But there's one particular story which is, it's amusing in a way, and thankfully and unusually nobody actually died. This was a young Royal Air Force pilot in 1919 who he has the strange record of being the first guy to crash a plane on the Isle of Man. And he crashed it only probably about a quarter of a mile from where we're speaking now at King William's College. And the story is that he was quite a good pilot. He'd been in France in the last year of the First World War, and he'd shot down several enemy aircraft. And this event happened just after the war. Everybody had relaxed a little bit, and there were still an awful lot of guys in the Royal Air Force. And crazy flying was rather a popular pastime. And this particular individual, Lieutenant Clear, was awaiting a court-martial for doing some rather foolish things in an aeroplane over near Chester. I believe he'd done a lot of low flying and possibly even flown under a bridge, which is the thing you see in sort of Hollywood movies, but not in Chester by a guy just acting the fool, basically. So he was not under quite lock and key, but he was under secure conditions. He managed to acquire an aeroplane and take it for a flight over the Irish Sea and landed at the Isle of Man, on the Isle of Man. He'd got relatives, I understand, in Ireland, and he was intending to fly over to Ireland, but somewhere over the sea, he managed to lose his way. So seeing the Isle of Man, he landed on a large, convenient field, which happened to be at King Bill's, to ask the way. Duly told which way to go, hopefully the correct direction. So he took off and started to do a bit of an aerobatic display for the numerous people who'd collected on the ground. Unfortunately for him, while he was in the middle of his aerobatics, one of the engine stopped working. It just ceased to function. So he had to glide down to land back in the field. And on landing, one of his wheels hit an obstruction or went into a ditch or something, and the aeroplane somersaulted and was broken to bits. He survived. He was a little bit bloodied and bruised, but no major injuries. I think he was carted off to the sick bay at King Bill's to be patched up. This happened on a Saturday afternoon, and the aeroplane was left overnight on Saturday, probably under guard. We're not absolutely sure about this, but whatever, whether it was under guard or not, by Sunday morning there was very little left of it. All the local people had been up to have a look at it and take a souvenir, as probably you would. So there was little more than the engine block, which nobody could drag away, it was so heavy. There's little more than that left. And we think, we're not absolutely certain, but we think we've got a souvenir from this aeroplane. There may be others out there. So to anybody seeing this, if you've got a bit of strange mechanical contrivance you're not quite sure about, bring it to the museum. Let us have a look. It might be a bit from this long missing SE-5 fighter plane. But one of the exhibits we've got in the museum is a control column, and it looks really much like a motorcycle handlebar or half of one. It's got various controls attached to it, and when it was brought in to us, it was brought in with the description, well, I think it's a bit of an aeroplane, but I'm not quite sure. It was brought in by a gentleman from the north of the island who bought it at the auctions years and years ago. He said whilst there was a little card with it with some information on it, it was so badly faded he couldn't read it. Which was unfortunate. But anyway, we've got it on display in the cabinet here. And it is a control column from an SE-5 fighter. We know no other SE-5s ever came to the Isle of Man. So there is quite a possibility that it does come from that aeroplane. It would be nice to be able to confirm it, but I don't think we can ever do that. But if it's a relic of the first air crash on the Isle of Man, then it's quite a significant thing. It's significant anyway, as is everything in the museum. So we hope you enjoy looking at it.